In this video, a list of the things you should definitely do when going on holiday to Tenerife. In this video, I want to focus on the things I would advise to most people going on holiday here. I also have specific tips for adults only or family holidays or traveling with small children on my website if you want to have more information. But as I said, in this video, I focus on the things that apply to pretty much everyone. I would advise everyone to do when going on holiday here. In this video, I also cover a few things that I should not have done that were a little bit too overpriced or that I think maybe you should avoid. So a few of those things in here, but mostly I focus on the things you definitely should do. The Siam Water Park, in my opinion, is simply awesome. I have been to a lot of water parks in Spain, but also in many other countries. I must say that this is definitely the best one I have been to, so I can definitely advise you to go and have a look there. I'm always very skeptical when an attraction claims to be the best water park in the world, or the best of anything in the world. In this case, they claim to be the best water park in the world. I haven't been to every water park in the world, of course, but from the ones I have been to, this is definitely a true claim and definitely a park I can advise you to go and visit. Garachico is a nice, authentic little town in between the south and the north. And while I enjoyed my coffee in the center of town, the main attraction here are the Piscinas Naturales El Cayetón. That was very hard to pronounce. These are naturally occurring set of swimming pools in the sea, so saltwater pools. They are free to enter and could offer a refreshing trip before continuing with your drive, whether you're driving from the north to the south of Tenerife or from the south to the north of Tenerife. If you take this side of the island, you will definitely enjoy taking a swim here before driving on. The dolphin and whale watching boats can be a lot of fun. Just make sure that you pick one of the better boats, as there are many different companies offering these type of excursions. While you are for sure going to see dolphins, 99% for sure, the whales might not show up. Just keep this in mind. It depends a little bit on the weather and just how lucky you are. But with swims and snorkeling often included and great views from the coastline, you are still for sure gonna have a great morning or afternoon or full day out. The Anaga Nature Reserve is located all the way in the north of Tenerife. While I did not know what to expect, it was amazing to me. I think it's one of the most jungle-like areas that you will find in Europe. Lush and green with lots of birds, salamanders, butterflies, a lot of fauna and flora. It's a nice area just to drive through, but there are many long and short hiking and walking tours here as well. So definitely, if you want to see a unique part of Tenerife, I would definitely advise you to go and have a look here. One of the most often claimed things that you do have to do is to visit Tide. I don't know how you pronounce this exactly in English, but if you want to go here, you could do it. Just keep it in mind, it's a long bus ride up there, and often it's also very crowded and a long way to take the cable cars up for the mountain. Personally, I'm not so big a fan of it during the daytime, but what I can advise you especially is to go in the evening or at sunset. There are organized excursions for this, but you can also drive up with your own car. If the weather is good, you will be treated to an amazing star sky. You can see almost nowhere else in Europe, or in the evening, a very nice place to see the sunset. So it depends a little bit on what you want to do. The daytime is the more common thing. It's fine. I'm personally not a big fan of it because there's just too many people and it takes away from the experience. But I would definitely advise you to visit Tide at night or in the evening. If staying in the south, drive to the north at least one day during your holiday. And if you're staying in the north, then drive to the south at least one day during your holiday. Well, the south is the most popular place to stay in Tenerife because of easy airport connection and the better microclimate in that area. It's a bit more dry there, there's less rain. The north is much more interesting in my opinion. It also looks completely different and much more lush and green it is in the north. This
is also where you will find some of the nicer and more secluded beaches on the island. So also if you like to go to some really nice beaches without all the tourists, then the north is also very interesting. Just to get to see the difference, I would advise you, if you're staying in the north, drive to the south at least one day. And if you're staying in the south, drive to the north at least one day. In the north of the island, in Puerto de la Cruz, you will find the Loro Park Zoo. This zoo is from the same company behind CM Water Park. That is the best water park in the world. And the same quality you will find in this zoo as well. There are lots of live shows in the park that keep it interesting for the entire family. So if you are anywhere near the north, definitely go and have a look at the Loro Park. If you're not anywhere near the north, you might still want to consider driving there, especially if you have a family with younger children, to go and have a look there at the zoo. Street flyers or street excursions, I normally call these kind of things. You will find them pretty much all over Spain and also many other destinations, but especially in the bigger resorts on Tenerife, like Playa de las Americas, Los Cristianos, and also Costa Adeje, you will find most of these. Leave these flyers alone if you see them. Normally they offer some kind of a cheap excursion, but it's often included some kind of a timeshare pitch or another long sales presentation that you have to sit through. So unless you want to waste a day to save a few euros on your excursions, leave these flyers where they are and don't pick them up. Just throw them in the trash if you see them. Don't go on these kind of excursions. Santa Cruz is the capital, and together with Puerto de la Cruz, the more real and authentic Tenerife, in my opinion. You will not find many tourists here, except for those who like to do shopping, as it is much cheaper here than many of the more touristic places on the island. There are lots of shopping centers here also, if you do like to shop. Also, for meals and drinks, you will pay much, much less than in the touristy areas of the south. Together with a visit to Enniger Nature Reserve or Playa de las Teresitas Beach, this makes for a great day out in the north of Tenerife. Whatever you do, don't buy any electronics in Tenerife. At least in my opinion, often people think that electronics are much cheaper in Tenerife because of the taxes, and in a way this is true, but the difference is not very big. However, there are lots of stores that take advantage of this. You can find many bad reviews online. Don't take my word for it. You can find these all over the internet. These are often selling you fake brands, or they run credit card scams on your credit card, or they're doing upselling or hard selling or any such thing. All these people act very nice, but they don't have your best interest in mind. If you don't need to buy any electronics urgently, then don't buy them in Tenerife. And if you do urgently need to buy electronics, I would advise you to go to one of the name brand stores, like you have a MediaMarkt in Tenerife. You can go and have a look there, but you will find that there are not very extreme cheap deals on Tenerife. Tenerife has several different water parks on the island. One thing I would say, do go to the CM Water Park. It's definitely the best one on the island. There are other ones on the island as well, and often they are cheaper. But since you are on Tenerife, I would definitely advise you to go to the CM Water Park. Spend a little bit more money, have an extremely good day out, and skip the other water parks. If you really want to travel on a budget, go to the other water parks. They're fine as well. But since you're here, spend a little bit more money. Don't let the money hold you back from visiting the best water park on the island, because it's definitely money well spent to go to the CM Water Park. Okay, so let's talk about Playa de las Teresitas for once. Like, this is also one of these things that look absolutely perfect on pictures, and it's a nice beach, but definitely not the prettiest one on Tenerife, in my opinion. There's lots of pictures from this that really make it like look like an amazing beach, and in my opinion it's really not. It's fine beach, it's a good beach, but there are many more nice beaches on Tenerife. To find your ideal beach, have a look at my holiday guide that I also have here on YouTube, where I discuss all the beaches in more detail. I'm sure there is a better one for you. However, if you are anywhere near Playa de las Teresitas, I'm not saying don't go and visit there, I'm just saying don't drive all across the island past many, many beautiful beaches just to end up at the Playa de las Teresitas, having left all those beaches beside you on your way that you didn't visit, because Playa de las Teresitas is nice, but it's also different other unique ones on the island. Know that you can find a full list of things to do and not do, as well as the companies I would advise you to book them at, on my website, or you can have a look at any of these other videos of mine where I give more holiday advice.